In this video, we're going to do some exercises to help with your hands and fingers. So the fingers and thumbs in particular do a lot of fine movement all day, every day, whether it's computer work or sewing or gardening or carpentry. You're using them all the time, and sometimes they can get stiff and tight and sore. Sometimes you can develop nodules in the palms of your hand, which mean that some fingers don't work as smoothly as they should. And often the problem extends up into your forearms, because this is where all the muscles for your fingers and thumbs start, and then they come down as tendons into your hands. So we're going to do some exercises that will help all of these areas and loosen your fingers and thumbs. So we're going to work on our forearms, and to do this you can either use an inflatable myofascial ball like this or a smaller trigger point ball, which is harder. So we're going to start with the myofascial ball. So it's important to work on your forearms to help loosen your fingers and your thumb. All of the muscles that work your fingers and thumb are found in your forearm on this side and on this side. So by working on both sides, you can help things to loosen. So to do this, if you find a nice hard surface, which could be a worktop or a desk or a table, place the ball on the surface and then just rest your forearm on the ball. Make sure that you keep your wrist and your hand nice and relaxed so that the tissues can release, and very slowly roll your forearm over the ball, working anywhere between your thumb and your elbow. And whenever you find a bit that feels tight or sore, just wait there for 90 seconds to 2 minutes to allow that to release and let go. And then you can continue on working up your forearm right the way up to just below your elbow. And when you've worked on this side, you can then turn your forearm over, again keeping your wrist and your hand nice and relaxed, and very slowly roll this side of your forearm over the ball. And again, waiting on any points that feel sore or tender to allow the tissues time to release. In this next exercise, we're going to work on the hands. And so your hands can get very tight. The fascia on the palm of your hands is quite thick, and sometimes it can get tight and start to create nodules of fascia, which actually form around the tendons of the muscles that work your fingers. So for some people, this can cause things like trigger finger or tightness in the thumb, which is Dupuytren's contracture. So by working with a ball on your palm of your hand, it can help to loosen some of these restrictions in your palm and to allow freer movement in your fingers and thumb. So for this, I'm using a trigger point ball. Just place the ball on the surface and then very slowly I'm going to roll my hand over the ball. So keeping my fingers and my thumb nice and relaxed. And if I find any areas that feel particularly tight or sore, I can wait on those for them to release. So you can keep going and actually work right up over your wrist. And likewise, you can come back down over your palm, over the pad of your thumb, and down to your fingers, and rolling over those as well. So any work that you do on your hand will also help to release from your hand up through your arm into your shoulder and your neck. So don't be surprised if you feel sensations elsewhere when you're doing this work. So in this exercise, we're going to do some stretches for the forearms. And this will help to loosen the muscles and the fascia and tendons in your forearms that work your fingers and thumbs. To do this at home, you can use any hard surface, so whether it's a desk, or I'm going to use a stool just because I'm kneeling on the floor here, or indeed you can do this when you're just sitting in a comfortable chair or a sofa that's got arms on it, because that's a good height as well for doing these exercises. So I'm just going to demonstrate using this stool. So if I pop this to the side, and I let my arm rest on the stool with my hand just hanging off the end. And so from here, I can just bring my other hand and then just start to pull the hand back towards the stool. So this is going to create a stretch in the top of my forearm. And progressively, I will start to feel things starting to release in my forearm, and I can go into a deeper stretch. And as long as I'm here for at least a couple of minutes, then the tissues in my forearm will be starting to release and let go. So I'm going to do the stretch on the other side of the forearm now. So placing my forearm on the stool again. So this time I've got the top of my forearm is on the stool, and so I'm going to be stretching the underside here. So just using the other hand to come in and just take my fingers and my thumb back towards the stool. So this is creating a stretch which you will be able to feel in your forearm, over your wrist, and coming down into your hand. So making sure it remains comfortable and that you stay in the stretch for at least a couple of minutes to allow time for the fascia and the tissues to start to let go. So in this exercise, we're going to do finger and thumb pulls. These are really good if your fingers feel particularly tight or stuck. And you can hold the finger at any point that's comfortable, but preferably not directly on the joints, which can sometimes feel a bit sore. So just holding the finger and just starting a gentle pull away from your hand. So this will start to create some space in the joints, and you'll almost get a sense of things lengthening and loosening, almost as if your finger is getting longer the longer you pull for. So as long as you do this for a couple of minutes, then the fascia will start to release, and then you can move on to this a different point on the same finger or onto a different finger. You can also do the stretch on your thumb. So just taking hold of your thumb and gently pulling it away from your hand. So by doing these pulls regularly, it can help to create more movement and less sense of stiffness in your fingers and your thumbs. So in this video, we've done some simple exercises that can help to loosen your fingers and thumbs and mean that you can continue to use your hands freely and easily without stiffness, tightness, or pain. You can find more exercises like these in our Living Pain-Free online video program, which is available on our website, as are our myofascial release kits.